Welcome to Naresh IT Technologies. This is Ramachandra. In the last video, I did talk about what is method in Java and why should we go for learning methods in Java language and when should we go for the method concept. Now, especially in this video, I'm going to talk about a few points related to static blocks and methods. Simply, let me write one question like, what is the difference between blocks and method? Very simple. The first difference is blocks executing automatically. Blocks executing automatically, whereas methods not executes automatically. This is the first point. The first point is blocks are executing automatically, whereas methods are not executes automatically. Now, let me give a small example on top of these points. So, let me take one notepad. Good. Here, block difference method BDM. Like, if you want to take any other name, you can take like a method demo. So, you guys know that if you want to execute the program in Java standard edition from Java 1.7 onwards, we required main method. Or now here I'm taking two things. One is static block, another one is method, one small method. Let me take either static method or non-static method. It is here not a problem. Let me taking one method like a static M1 method. So let me write one small println statement for more clarity purpose. What is this? A static block. Good. And what is this? It is M1 method. Static M1 method. Good. And let me take class name like file name like method demo.java. Now let me take one normal SOP statement in the main method. So this is my program. Now observe guys, for executing this program I required command prompt. I'm navigating to the desktop and method demo. Good. And here I'm writing like Java method demo. Now if you are seeing this output, we can understanding what is that static block executing and main method is also executing. But if you comes to the M1 method is not executes automatically. Maybe you guys are getting one controversy point like main is also one method. How it will be executing automatically? Basically, the main method execution statement already written in the JVM software. That's why main method executing automatically, not main method executing automatically. That's why main method executes after successfully completion of the static initialization phase. Otherwise, main method is also not executes. Simply, we can say in our program, I mentioned three programming elements mainly. One is static block, two static methods. One is M1 method, another one is what here? Main method. Among this M1 method and main method, which method is executing? Only main method executing, not M1 method. In entire Java, there is one standard rule, that is, no method will be executing automatically. If we want to execute programmatically, we need to call methods. Programmatically, if you want to execute, what we need to do? Programmatically, we need to call those methods. Otherwise, no method in the Java language executes automatically. But whereas blocks are executes automatically. So this is one first point. Now, second point. What is the second point, sir? Very simple. I hope you understand this first point. Here simply let me give you a brief idea. I have two methods and one block. but only static block and main method is executing, but not M1 method. The reason is no method will be executing automatically. But again, you have an idea like, sir, why main method is executes? The reason is main method calling statements already written in the JVM software by the Java community people. That's why main method is executes. Otherwise, main method is also not executes. This is the first difference. The second one is blocks doesn't have identity, whereas method have identity. What is the meaning of identity? It's a one word or name which is used to recognize any particular item as a unique. That is called identity. For example, int a equal to 10, int b equal to 20. So what happened? JVM will provide the memory for a in the 10 value placed, and JVM will provide the memory for b and 20 value placed. How to differentiate over that 10 existing memory and 20 existing memory with the support of variable name like what? A and B. In the I have one student class, I have one employee class. In the student class, I have one method like write. In the employee class, I have a method like what? Type. How to differentiate this method to that method with the support of what? Identities like write and type. And one more example. I have one class name like bank, and one more class name like what here? Institute. Bank having some functionality and institute having some functionality. How to differentiate this functionality with the support of what? Class name. So class names also comes under what here? Identity. Simply we can say identity, it's a name which is used for differentiate from one programming element to another programming element. For example, if I'm writing like one more static block, control C, control V, this is block 2, this is block 1, save it. Now Java C method demo dot Java and Java method demo, then what happened? Blocks are executing, but if you want to call those blocks, we can't. The reason is we are unable to differentiate this block to this block. The name is, say, observe, what's the keyword? We have only static. It is also static. So we are unable to differentiate one block to another block. That's why we are unable to call explicitly. If you are able to differentiate one block to another block, definitely we can able to call. But we are unable to, that's why we are unable to differentiate one block to another block. That's why we are unable to call them. If you are able to differentiate, definitely we can able to call like methods. For example, M1 method and one more method we have. What is that one more method? For example, copy this one and paste here. Now here I'm writing like what here? M2. Now I can able to differentiate with the support of what? Method name. So if I able to differentiate them one method to another method, definitely we can go for what? Calling. Now observe here, Java C method demo dot Java, and what is this? Why M1 method 1 is already existed. I did copy paste here. It is what here? M2. Java C method demo dot Java and Java method demo. Then what happened here? Static M1 method and M2 methods are executing. So in our program, in our Java language, we can able to differentiate one method to another method. That's why we can able to call them. Otherwise, we can't. It's not possible. So what is the second point here? Blocks doesn't having identity. That's why we are unable to call them explicitly. They are always executing automatically by the JVM. Whereas methods having some identity, we can able to differentiate one method to another method with the support of what here? Identity. Once we are able to differentiate one method to another method, definitely we can able to call them explicitly by using our Java programming calling statements. That is the second one. Blocks are executes the way we mention in the program from top to bottom. Whereas methods are executes the way we calling. The way we calling means what here? The way means what? The order we calling. Way means here. The way means what here? Order we calling the methods. For example, I have M1 method and M2 method. In the previous program, if you observe here, I have a M1 method as well as what here M2 method. How I'm calling? First M1 method I'm calling, later M2 method calling. If you observe this one, if you observe the output, we can understand first M1 method executing, later M2. So what is the meaning here? Whereas methods are executing, they are order calling the methods. The reason is, see, in which order I'm calling? First M1, later M2. So in which order they are going to be executing? First M1, later M2. For example, if you are trying to change, if you are changing like this, this is the M2 method and this is the M1 method, then observe, if you observe the output, we can give the great conclusion here. So first in the previous example, first I'm calling the M1 method, that's why it will executing what here, M1 method first. In this program I'm calling the M2 method first, that's why M2 method executing first. So that's why I given one third definition. What is that? The way we are calling the methods, in the same order those methods will be executing, whereas blocks, the way we mentioned in the program from top to bottom. That is the third difference. And one more difference. What is the one more difference? We can't write return statements. We can't return statement with or without value. Whereas in methods, we can write return and return with without argument and return with value or without value, whatever it may be, based on the method return type. So let me show you this one. If you are writing return, just return, what happened, observe. Now if you are trying to write, I'm getting one exception. What is that? Return outside method. See, what is the main intention of the return statements? To forward the control, as well as meanwhile of forward the control, sometimes carrying the information, sometimes what you are not carrying the information from called area to calling area. But here, are we calling the static blocks explicitly? No. If you are not calling the static blocks explicitly, how the control is coming from static block to our area? It's not possible. Who will calling here? Static block JVM. So how the control is going from our program to JVM? It's not possible. So once a static block ends, automatically the control go to what here? If you are able to write return statement in the static block, definitely our control is going from where to where? Our program to JVM program. Why? The reason is, who calling the static blocks? JVM. So definitely if you are able to write return statement, the control goes to where here? JVM program. What about the remaining static blocks? Not executed. So this is not valid. And mainly, blocks are designed for what? Blocks are designed for, static blocks are designed for static variable initialization purpose. Non-static blocks are designed for initialize the non-static variables, but not carrying the information. But not carrying the information from one area to another area. For example, if you are calling, if JVM calling the static block, then what happened here? JVM intention is not taking some information from the static block. The main intention of the JVM to call the static block is to initialize what here? Static variables. Not JVM not having intention like carrying, getting some information from the static block. So if you are trying to write a return statement with value, that is also what here? Error. So simply we given one answer like, within the static block, we can't write any return statements. Whereas in methods, I can able to write return. And for example, let me take this is int. Now here I'm writing like, we will see more and more information about return and return statement things also. Return statement things means what? Return statement values. Now observe. Let me write M2 method calling in the SOP. Yes. Java C method demo dot Java, Java method demo. Then what happened? I'm calling the static method, it will returns what? 111. I'm calling the M1 method, it will not returns anything. The reason is, M1 method return type is what here? Wide. So nothing it will giving. Just forwarding the control from called area to calling area. Now I am calling, from main method I'm calling. So what happened? Control is going from here to here. After completion of the M1 method execution, definitely the control must and should be coming to where? Main method. How? With the support of a return statement. But whereas static blocks not having return statement, the reason is, who calling the static block? JVM. If the controller is again going to the JVM, who will execute the remaining static blocks? That's why we can't write what your return statements in static blocks. That is what your one more difference. And one more thing is, let me show you one thing. Practically, later we will go for programmatically. Throws some, I'm writing like exception. Now, the same thing I'm writing after M1 method also. Let me write after main method. Control Z. Let me write here. It's not copied properly. So here I need to write what? Throws exception. Let me copy this one. Let me paste here. Now let me compile this program. What happened? We will get to an exception. What is that? Illegal start of type, as well as it will asking like a semicolon expected. That means by seeing this error, we can giving one more conclusion related to blocks and methods. See guys, here compiler will giving the only information related to error related to what here? Static block throws keyword. But it will not giving any information related to what here? Main method throws keyword. What is the meaning of that? We cannot throws any exceptions in blocks. Whereas from method, we can throws exceptions also. So these are the main differences. The first difference is blocks executing automatically, whereas methods not. The reason is, so blocks doesn't having any identity, so programmer unable to call it. The programmer unable to call it, Java software itself calling by using what here JVM. If you are able to differentiate one method to another method based on our requirement, we can able to what? Calling the methods. For example, I want to withdraw some money. So if to withdraw the money, I'm going to ATM machine. Once I'm going to the ATM machine, how ATM machine can understand whether this person is coming for withdrawal or whether this person is coming from deposit or whether this person is coming from what? Balance inquiry. So ATM machine unable to understand for what purpose the end user coming into that particular machine. So end user must and should be provide some information. End user must and should be tell to ATM machine for what purpose he or she coming to that ATM machines or ATM center. How the end user can able to interact with the ATM machine with the support of method calling. Clicking on withdrawal button is nothing but what? We are internally communicating or we are internally calling withdrawal method. And clicking on balance inquiry button is nothing but the end user calling what your balance inquiry method. So in the real world, clicking on box, clicking on inbox or clicking on send box or clicking on withdrawal and clicking on balance inquiry meaning what? Internally we are going to execute some logic. Executing some logic with the support of what your method. Simply we can say whatever the operations we are going to do in the real world, we need to do in the real world. Definitely we need to interact with those operation by clicking on buttons. Now blocks doesn't having any identity, already we discussed. Blocks executes the, yes, blocks are executing the way we mentioned in the program from top to bottom. So already I told you, like I showed the program, like first I mentioned static block 1, later block 2, how they are printing output 1 and 2. So first I'm writing this static block, later this one, that's where they are executing what here, first this one, later this one. But whereas the methods, that is entirely depend upon what your calling style. If you're executing the, if you're calling the M1 method first, M1 method executing. If you're calling M2 method first, first M2 method executes. And one more difference is, we can't write a return statement and return statement with the value in the static blocks or blocks, but whereas in methods we can able to write, as well as throws also we can't write in the blocks, whereas in the methods we can able to write. So this is the main difference between blocks as well as methods. In the next video, I'm going to talk about how to write the method syntax. And what are the types of methods do we have? So that type of interesting issues we will see in the next video. I hope you enjoy this video very well. For more videos, please subscribe Naresh IT channel. Thank you.